there are many brands of pasta from Italy. Of the two most famous available worldwide, the Cecco is surely the better one, that delivers a nice consistent result every time. Although, let's move on to the big players. Here at the center we have Masciarelli, a great producer from Abruzzo, the most uncontaminated region of Italy. Their pasta is completely handmade using carefully selected durum wheat, dried over an extremely long period of time in order to preserve the full flavor of the grain. Similarly, the one on my left, Monograno Felicetti, is produced in Trentino, at the footsteps of the Italian Alps, at 1,000 meters altitude, with a dedicated natural spring, they control the entire journey of their products from the grain to the pasta. Both arguably the best products in Italy, and you can really smell it when cooking. It makes you feel like you are in a wheat field in the Italian countryside. They both boost outstanding flavor and consistency. Tomato sauce is a very simple recipe, at the same time, is one of the hardest to master. The complexity and volatility of its ingredients require much sensibilities to get the best taste. Today, I will show you two ways to do it, one using very good tomatoes from Sardinia and one with not so great industrial tomatoes from an Italian brand but of unknown origins, and how to deal with them without using shortcuts like sugar that would alter the essence of the tomatoes. Both require extra virgin olive oil, high quality sea salt, very important to bring out the natural sweetness of the tomatoes, dry mild whole chilies, and freshly ground white pepper. The chilies and the pepper are not there to add spiciness to the sauce, but to round and support the flavor of the canned tomatoes. When you have very good tomatoes, you don't need to add much at all, but just help them to bring out their best. You can tell good canned tomatoes by tasting them raw. The better they are, the more will feel good to be eaten and cooked. While the industrial ones will be acidic, watery and a bit bland, the natural sweetness of the onions and the other aromatics will help to cope with those unwanted attributes. In the other case, the basil will complement and enlighten the natural aroma of the tomatoes. Let's talk garlic and Italian food. One of the most important things in Italian cuisine is balance and equilibrium. All flavors must play together like an orchestra and set the stage for the main performer, in this case, the tomato. Garlic strength varies from country to country and region to region, and for authentic Italian cuisine, you need to learn how to adjust for it. All you need to know is that in Italian cuisine, with very few exceptions, garlic almost never take the stage, especially in tomato sauces. If you can clearly feel the taste of garlic in the sauce, it means it's too much. Let's separate the leaves from the stems, but don't throw them away. Since there are not any solids in the first sauce, we start by milling the tomatoes. You could also crush them by hand, and actually many people prefer a chunky sauce. Blender is my least favorite. The incorporation of air changes the bright red color of the tomatoes. So, if you use the blender, regulate it on the lowest speed and proceed by pulses. Once done, scrape out all the smashed cores from the inside of the mill. We don't waste anything here. Now all the ingredients are ready. Let's start with the aromatic oil. Over 250 grams of tomatoes, I use 30 to 40 grams of extra virgin olive oil, one dry mild chili, one clove of garlic lightly smashed, and the basil stems. Allow a gentle fry until the garlic is slightly golden brown and the chili have turned dark red. At this point, remove everything and reserve. Immediately in with the tomatoes, otherwise the oil will burn. And stir well, making sure everything is nicely emulsified. Like me, if you like garlic, this is the best time to add it back to the sauce. You could add back the chili as well, but the tomatoes in this case are so good that I prefer to leave it out. Add salt, very important to keep the acidity of the tomatoes at bay. The better the tomatoes, the less salt you'll need. And cook in a gentle simmer until ready. This is the hardest step when making tomato sauce, deciding when it's ready. Usually it takes between 10 to 20 minutes. Every time is different, even using the same brand. There is a little magic time window that lasts only a minute or less, in which all the volatile flavors of the ingredients come together and give their best. it is actually easier smelling it than tasting it. Not long past that point, the perfume will stop and the sauce will lose flavor exponentially. So, before that happens, immediately out and put it in a different container to cool down. Now for the second one. Smash the tomatoes by hand, the garlic just like before, and the onions, first in half, then lengthwise. Make sure you reach with the knife all the way in. Always careful to keep your fingers above the blade and take your time, no one is rushing you. Another tip when cutting onions, don't just push straight down, but slide instead. In doing so, you will lose less juice. This has two benefits, less tears for you, and all the precious juices and sugars will be kept inside to be released in the sauce. Do the same for the other half and let's keep the two separated. Now let's start with a cold sauce pot. Add half of the onions and again 30 to 40 grams of extra virgin olive oil. Season with a pinch of salt and freshly ground white pepper. Let's start simmering on a medium-low heat until all the liquid will be evaporated. When the onions are about to begin browning, in with the garlic and the chili. When you see big bubbles forming in the oil, it means that the sugars are starting to caramelize. At this point, the onion should be golden in color, and we can add the other half. Mix together for 10 seconds, and in with the tomatoes. I do this because I want the entire flavor spectrum of the onions, the nice sweet caramelized notes and the fresh spiky notes that normally will be destroyed in the caramelization process. This procedure will give an entire new dimension to your sauce. From here, it is just like the previous sauce, depending on the tomatoes and how fine you cut your onion. It will be ready in 15 to 25 minutes. Add the rosemary 1 minute before you turn off the heat. This way, it will give all its best to the sauce. Remove all the aromatics and taste for seasoning. In my case, I felt the need to add a bit more of salt and olive oil. Now, into the food mill and keep milling until there is no more pulp coming out of the bottom. At the end, you will be rewarded with this luxurious and beautiful sauce. Now, in a large pot of boiling water, add some high-quality sea salt. To give you a good idea of the amount of salt, the water has to be like a slightly oversalted soup. 15 grams per liter would be optimal. If you hold your spaghetti perpendicular right above the center of the pot and slightly twisting both ends in opposite direction and letting them fall, they will arrange themselves in a spiral. Push them down and mix them only a few times during cooking. Often, I see people mixing the crap out of the pasta. If the water is nicely boiling, there is absolutely no need to do so. Let the pasta relax with care and love. Now, time to marry the pasta with the sauce. First of all, here we are not cooking the sauce any further. These poor tomatoes already have been cooked twice. First at the can in the factory and then by us just now. So, any further evaporation will be a loss in flavor. So, keep the heat very low. Add the basil leaves and the pasta. And add more tomato sauce if needed. Many say to add pasta water at this stage, but for tomato sauce I respectfully disagree. It changes the consistency and the shine of the sauce, and it causes for a flavor loss. Once nicely combined, remove the basil leaves. Put the pasta on a plate. spoon over that amazing sauce left in the pan. And add some fresh basil leaves. Sprinkle with Parmigiano Reggiano, or pecorino, or even ricotta salata is perfect if you find it. Time to enjoy this timeless classic, so iconic of our cuisine. The tomatoes, the cheese, the basil make for an umami nuclear bomb. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, leave a comment and subscribe. I'll see you next week.